Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. In this video series, I am explaining you tree data structure. Here in this right up corner, I am providing you a shortcut link for all the details about tree data structure. If you want to know more about tree data structure, you can refer my previous video by clicking on this I. In this current video session, I am explaining you the post-order binary tree traversal with few solved examples. Here I am trying to explain the post-order traversal with the animation for the solving of the examples. Before moving to the content, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. Before moving to the post-order traversal, you must know what different techniques are there for the tree traversal. Binary tree will be traversed in these main two ways. They are nothing but the depth first traversal technique and the breadth first traversal technique. So depth first traversal technique, there are three sub techniques. They are nothing but pre-order, in-order and post-order, where this pre, in and post will be the position of a root node, that is pre before left and right child, in order means in between of the left and right child, and post order is nothing but after left and right child. If you want to know more details about these different tree traversal techniques, I am providing again a shortcut link for a playlist of the binary tree traversal where I have covered everything in detail for all the three traversal techniques. And the breadth first traversal technique is nothing but the level order traversal technique where the tree will be traversed in the level. Now here I am focusing on the solved example of post order traversal. So now let's start with the binary tree traversal in post order, where we are following a sequence of left node or a left subtree, right node or a right subtree, and a root node at the end, because it is a post order traversal. The same thing I am trying to explain over here. So we have to first of all go for a left subtree, then a right subtree, and at the end we have to process a root node because it is a post order. The position of a root node will be after left and right subtree. Here in short, I am explaining you the sequence or the number of steps that we supposed to follow. So after starting with a root node, let's check for a left child. If it is having a left child, let's check for again a left child. And after that, if we are at the leftmost child, after processing of the left child, we supposed to check for a right child. If it is having a right child, let's make it as a root node. Let's again check for its left child. If it is again having a left child, process it, and again let's check for a left child. If it is not, let's again check for a right child. If it is present, process it, and at the end, let's assume you have processed the left child as well as right child. Now it's turn to process a root node. So these steps we supposed to follow, and here I'm reminding these steps with the help of first solved example. This is a very simple solved example where three nodes are there. A is a root node, B and C are its left and right childs respectively. So what will be a post order traversal? We supposed to start with a root node. After root node, we have to check for a root node whether it is having a left child or not. Let's check whether A is having left child. Yes, it is having a left child. So let's step down to its left child, and we are making this B as a root node. Let's make B as a root node. Let's again check whether B is having left child. No. B is having right child. No. So we have to process this B in this post order traversal. So I have processed it. After that, we have to return back to a root node and let's check for its right child. Here you can see that A is having a right child, so that's why we are step downing to the right child of a root node A. Let's make C as a root node and let's check whether it is having a left child or not. it is not having a left child, it is not having a right child as well. So that's why we have to process C as a root node, and we have to return back to a root node A. And as we have done with its left child as well as right child, it's turn to process a root node. So that's why let's move back to the root node and process it. Now let's move forward for the example number two, where we have to follow the same steps. They are left, right and a root node. So this is my example where we supposed to start with a root node. So let's start with a root node. After starting with a root node, let's check whether 10 is having its left child. Yes, it is having its left child. So that's why I step down to its left child, that is 20. Make it as a root node. Let's check whether 20 is having left child. No. Let's check 20 is having right child. Yes. So step down to 30 as a right child of 20, and now make 30 as a root node. After making it as a root node, let's check for its left child. Yes, it is present. Step down to 50 as a its left child and make it as a root node. After making it as a root node, let's check whether 50 is having left child. No. Whether 50 is having right child. No. So it's turn to process a root node, that is 50. Let's return back to 30 and move to the right child if it is present. Yes. In the case of 30, the right child is present, so step down to the right child. Make 60 as a root node. Let's check whether 60 is having its left child. No. 60 is having right child. No. So that's why process 60, and we have processed it. And now you have to return back to a parent node, that is nothing but 30, is nothing but a root node in this subtree. Now as for 30, we have processed its left child, we have processed it its right child, and now it's turn to process a root node, that is nothing but 30, and I have processed it. Return back to its root node, 30's root node, and here you can see that for the root node 20, we have done with its left child, we have done with its right subtree as well, and now it's turn to process a root node, that is 20. Let's return back to 10, but now here for 10, we have done with only its left subtree. The right subtree is remaining, so that's why let's check whether 10 is having its right child or not. Yes, it is having a right child, so that's why move to the right child of 10 and make it as a root node. Let's make 40 as a root node and let's check whether 40 is having left child. No. 40 is having right child. No. So that's why process 40 and after that return back to the root node, and here you can see that we have done with its left subtree already. Currently we have done with its right subtree, and now it's turn to process a root node. So let's process it. So here in this way we can execute, we can traverse a tree in post order traversal. Now let's move forward for the next example. Here a next example, we supposed to follow the same steps again, and this is the tree available with you. Here we are going to start with a root node, that is 10. Let's check for its left child. It is present, so that's why step down to 22. Make it as a root node. Let's check for a left child. It is again present. Step down to 44. Make it as a root node. For 44, no left child, no right child, so that's why process it and move to the right child of 22. Make it as a root node. Again 55 as a left node, no left child, no right child, process it and move, return back to 22 and process it. Return back to 11 again. Let's check for its right child as we have done with its left subtree. It's time to move to the right subtree if it is present. Yes, it is present, so that's why I step down to 32 as making it as a root node. After making 33 as a root node, let's check for a 33 as a left child whether it is present or not. Yes, it is present. Step down to the left child of 33. Let's make 66 as a root node and check whether 66 is having left child. No. 66 is having right child. No. So that's why process 66 and return back to 33 to check the right child present or not. As 33 is having right child, let's step down to the right child of 33 and make it as a root node. After making 77 as a root node, its left child is not present, its right child is also not present, so that's why process 77 and return back to a root node 33. Let's process it as we have done with its left child and right child. We have processed 33 and return back to its root node, that is nothing but 11. Here again you can see that we have done with its left subtree, we have done with its right subtree. Now it's turn to process a root node 11 and we have processed it. So in this way we have traversed the given binary tree in post order traversal. The post order traversal will be 44, 55, 22, 66, 77, 33, and at the end the root node will be processed is nothing but 11. Let's move forward for the next example by reminding the same steps. This is my tree. If you have understood the concept of post order traversal, you can pause the video. You can try to traverse the given tree in post order by your own, and at the end you can check whether you have done whatever the post order traversal you are having is correct or not by comparing your answer with my answer. So let's start with a root node. Let's move to the left child, not present. Let's move to the right child. Yes, it is present. So step down to right child and make it as a root node. Let's check for its left child. Yes, it is present. Step down to 66 and make it as a root node. No left child is present. No right child is present. So that's why process it and return back to 33 to check whether it is having 77 as a right child or not. Yes, the 77 is right child. So that's why make it as a root node by stepping down to the right child. After stepping down to the right child, make it as a root node and let's check for its left child. No left child is present. Let's check for a right child. Yes, right child is present. So step down to the right child and make it as a root node. Again, for 22, let's check whether it is having left child. Yes, step down to its left child and make it as a root node. After making 44 as a root node, let's check for its left child, not present. Let's check for its right child, not present. And now process 44. After processing 44, let's return back to 22 and check whether 22 is having its right child or not. Yes, it is having right child, so step down to the right child and make it as a root node. After making it as a root node, let's check for its left child, not present. Let's check for a right child, not present. That's why process 55. And after this, here you can see that we have to return back to its root node is nothing but 22. Return back to 22. As for 22, we have done with its left subtree, we have done with its right subtree. Now it's turn to process 22. After processing of 22, let's return back to its parent node or its root node. 77 will be a root node. We have done with its left subtree as it was not present. We have done with the right subtree as well. And now here it's turn to process a root node 77. So I have processed it. Return back to its root node, that is its previous level, will be 33. After moving to the 33, we have done with its left subtree, we have done with its right subtree. Now it's turn to display or to process 33 as a root node. And at the end, move back to 11, make it as a root node. And we have done with its left subtree, we have done with its right subtree. Now it's turn to process a root node 11. So in this way we have done with the post order traversal for the given binary tree. The post order traversal for given binary tree is 66, 44, 55, 22, 77, 33 and 11. And this is the last example for this post order traversal solved example. If you have understood the concept very well, then you can apply your own the steps for the post order traversal. And let's start with the root node. Let's check for its left child. Left. Yes, I am at the leftmost child. Now there is no any left child is present, no any right child is present. Process it and return back to D. As D is not having right child, process a root node D. Return back to B. As B is having its right child, move it to the right child. And no left right child present for a node E, let's process it. return back to B, process it, return back to A, but after returning A, do not process it because we have only done with its left subtree till the right subtree is remaining. So let's check for a right subtree. Yes, right subtree is present. Step down to the right child of A. Let's see over here. C is its right child. Make it as a root node. No left child. So that's why I move to the right child. For F, let's check for a left child. Yes, it is present. Step down to H as a left child. No left right child present for H, as H is a leaf node. Process it and let's go back to F. Let's check for its right child. Yes, it is present. Step down to the right child, that is I, and for I, again it is a leaf node. Process it. Return back to F, process it, return back to C, process it, and return back to A and process it. So in this way we have done with the post order traversal for the given binary tree. Here we have done with the 5 solved examples for the post order traversal. Now at the end of this video tutorial, I hope you must have understood the concept of post order traversal very well. So thank you all dear friends for listening and watching my video. If you like the video and its content, please do not forget to give the comment. If you are having any query, any doubt, you can post your query doubt in the comment section below. I'll try to solve it. Here for your reference, I am providing a shortcut link for a next video of this video series along with the whole video series in the form of playlist. If you have not subscribed my channel, I am providing a subscription link for my channel Tech Talks as well. Please do subscribe my channel Tech Talks and do share with your friends. Stay tuned with Tech Talks. Happy learning, happy data structuring. Thank you.